Hi, this is P.R. Sundar. Welcome to Mission Options. In this episode, we are going to talk about an exciting topic called option selling. And you all must know that P.R. Sundar is a very famous option seller. I have made more than 10 crore rupees profit in the last financial year only through option selling. And this is the place where really people make very good profit. But however, not everything is very simple, and there are so many drawbacks also. So we will discuss that one by one. First, what is option selling? We have already seen some videos about option buying, and whatever you just do opposite, that is called option selling. Let us say market is trading around 14,500, 14,600. This video is being shot on 18th of April. And let us say for 1 month down the lane, say by end of May, and if people feel that market will surely go up, and if the people think market will surely go above 15,000, and people will go and buy 15,000 call option. So I'm going to show you here from NSE option chain. I've chosen the expiry date 27th May. And if I come to the option chain, the left side is calls, right side is puts. The center one is a strike price. So last trading day, Nifty closed around 14,617. And if you look at the 15,000 call option, is being traded at 230 rupees. So last traded price is 230.90 rupees. Just to recap what we have seen already, if you buy this option, you have to pay 230 rupees per share. Of course, you have to buy in lots. Minimum lot is 75 now. Just for the sake of simplicity, we will just talk for one share. So if you feel that market will go above 15,000, you go and buy a 15,000 call option, you have to pay 230 rupees and you are known as option buyer. And opposite me, I'm an option seller. Let us say I'm not bullish. I'm not expecting market to go up. I'm expecting market to go down or may go up slightly, but not beyond 15,000. Then I will be the one selling the option to you. There are many people in India, I can tell you, they know only option buying. When I talked to one of my friends about selling of option, he said, is it? There is such something? I thought we can only buy, we can never sell. Then I asked him, how can you buy something when nobody is selling? So you are buying something means that somebody is selling. Yeah, I did not think about this line. So many people, many brokers, many channels, they encourage only buying and they are not encouraging selling. Of course, selling has a lot of risk that we will talk later. So if you are bullish, if you think market will go higher during the next 1 month, you go and buy a 15,000 call option, you pay 230 rupees per share, you are a buyer. And I am a seller. So the money that you pay 230 rupees will come to me, right? Okay. Now, let us look at the payoff chart. So here, I'm showing you the payoff chart for options, 27th May, 15,000 call option, buy call option. And this is your payoff chart. And you see, though you are bullish and though you feel that market will go above 15,000, there is a possibility you will lose money even if it goes above 15,000. Let us say Nifty go and close around 15,200. What you said is true. It has gone above 15,000. But how much it has gone above 15,000? It has gone 200 point above 15,000. So that means you will receive only 200 rupees. But you paid 230 rupees. Now you receive only 200 rupees. You still lose 30 rupees. So though you are buying a 15,000 call option, but your break-even is not 15,000. Your break-even is 15,000 plus 230, the premium you paid. That means you can make profit only if Nifty goes above 15,230. That is for option buyer. But how about option seller? Option seller says market will not go above 15,000, but even if the market goes above 15,000, there is a possibility that he can make profit. Let us say market closes at 15,200. The seller will have to return 200 rupees to the buyer. But he already received 230 rupees from the buyer. So still he has 30 rupees profit. So in a way, option seller make profit even if bet has gone wrong. The option seller will start losing the money only if the Nifty goes above 15,230. So you can look here the payoff chart for buyer. The buyer will make money only if the market goes above 15,230. As long as market is trading below 15,230, he will lose the money. And more importantly, look at the probability of profit. The probability of profit is only about 25% for buyer. Now, the same chart I'm going to show for seller. And here, this is a 15,000 call option seller. The seller makes profit as long as market not going above 15,230. As long as he's below that, he make profit. And what is the probability of profit? So it is almost 75%. Why the probability is more for option seller? And let me tell you, let us say market trading around 14,500, 14,600. You are an option buyer, you are bullish, and you are buying a 15,000 call option for 230 rupees. There are five things that can happen. Market can fall drastically. In that case, you will lose everything. Market can fall slightly. Also, you lose everything. Market can go sideways. You still lose everything. Market can go up slightly. Means like from 14,600 to 15,000 or 15,100. You still lose. So you make profit only when the market moves significantly higher. Whereas option seller, market falls significantly, he make profit. Market falls slightly, he make profit. Market goes sideways, still he make profit. Market goes slightly higher from 14,600 to 15,200. Also he make profit. And he loses only when the markets move significantly higher. So the same thing opposite in the put option. If you are bearish, if you are expecting market to go down below 14,000, you may buy a 14,000 put option. That 14,000 put option is trading around 165 rupees. And this is the payoff chart for option seller. So I'm bullish. I'm not expecting market to go below 14,000. So I make profit. If the market goes significantly higher, I make profit. If it goes slightly higher, I make profit even if it goes sideways. And even I make profit even if the market falls 14,000 or even up to 13,835, I make profit. So I lose only if the market falls below 13,835. Whereas for option buyer, this is the payoff chart, and he lose money if the market goes significantly higher, lose money slightly go higher, lose money if market goes sideways, lose money even if it falls, and he makes money only if the market falls significantly lower. That is why you can see the probability of profit is only about 20% for buyer. And whereas for seller, the probability of profit is around 80%. We have seen the payoff chart for option buying and option selling. And let me tell you, they are all as of expiry date. And along the way, these option prices may go higher or may go lower depending upon the market conditions. Normally, if markets move higher, call options prices move higher. If markets move lower, put option prices move higher. So whatever the payoff chart and I've shown you, they are as of expiry date. You don't have to wait until the end of the expiry to close your positions. In between, if you are profitable, you want to exit, you can always exit the positions. So now you know why some people go for option selling. Then comes a logical question. If the probability of winning is so high for option selling, naturally everyone should be the seller. But practically, if you see, out of 100 people in the market, there is hardly one or two people are sellers. The remaining 98, 99 people are option buyers only. Why? That I will be explaining in my next video. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you for watching.